Hi everyone, hope you are preparing really well, and I think this is the most important video for everyone because I think there are a lot of people who are giving interviews and they are switching. So I think in 2021 the level has been a little up, and they are asking more questions. And in testing, the main problem is like there are a lot of competition. So if you don't know even one or two questions, so they may not select you. And even there's a problem when because I have also experienced this thing, and because we think that we know this these all things, but at the time of interview we might not cover that topic and we might forgot, and at the time of interview we were not able to give them the satisfactory answer. So I have not given much interviews, but I have given some interviews to see how the market is going on, and what all skills we required to get a good job, like your dream job. And even the market is really up. If you want, you can try it up. You can even get 100 or 70% hike if you're not getting it in your current organization. So I think this video is I'm covering the topics as well as the questions related to the topic. I didn't get the time to write everything, but while explaining, and I might give you the questions as well. So I request you to listen all the entire video, so it will not take your much time. But I think this is very helpful for you, like if you're preparing and what all questions you get from those topics. I think you should have, if you look into that, you might know it, but just be into the in your cache memory. So let's quickly jump into the video. So the basic programming, so we might not know about the programming, and because we are the testers and we mostly work into manual as well as on automation, so we might know the automation stuff, so we can create the scripts and all, but you don't sometimes we don't know the logics of the programs, how things works, like sorting of an array. And the sorting of an array is very important thing that you have to know. Remove duplicates and remove duplicates. I think these two questions most of the organization ask. I think I've given in Mindtree, I think that there was a question called this one, that I have to sort an array and remove duplicates and reverse a string. I think these are the common questions. So if you find the common thing, you should know. So you should, and you have to practice this. It's just not like you just see it and you'll be able to do it. It's not at all happening. You have to practice it every single day. You have to write the code. Then only you'll be able to write the code. And you have to understand the logics and everything, whatever, I think these logics are similar. Like if you sit back and see, the logics are similar. So you know how to work with programming, like how to sort an array and everything. Like it may go to difficult level, but in some organization they may ask you a less question, and try practicing on notepad, because sometimes they don't give you an option to write it on Eclipse. So you should know, because sometimes we use control space and we get the suggestions, so we won't get that option into the notepad. So start preparing it in notepad, so it will be helpful for you at the time of interview. I think that this is the pro tip for you guys, and that's why I'm saying that listen to me in the interview. And I think that if you give me 15 minutes of time, that will help it will help you in your interview. Second is collections. So collections, very important topic. So in collection, the main thing are array list and linked list. So you should know the difference of array list and linked list, and hash map and hash table. I think these are the four topics which is commonly used in an interview. So just understand the concept of array list. Array list is very important, so you have to understand array list. You learn array list in and out. So I think array list is the most important question. So if you're going in some great company, so they may ask you questions related to array list as well and linked list. And linked list, we know the definition, but if you learn it through program, so if someone gives you program also, you'll be able to write it along, even with the maps also. So map, even you used it in your framework also. Map we usually use for your data-driven framework, right, to read the data, like in the form of hash map, because they works on key and value pairs. So you can give the example of HashMap also that you have used in your framework, like HashMap, and where you use these all concepts and like collection, where and all you have used it, collection in your framework. So I think that is also you have to look into. And yeah, I think this is pretty much okay. Like if you give the like this these many sets and everything, why are you using it, list where and all you'll be using it, like linked list. We in real time we use like linked list, right? So it will be like doubly linked list if you want to give the example. So it is like your music list, right? Music playlist. So you'll be having, you can easily navigate it to previous and the next, right? So I think that is the real time example of your linked list. So okay, so static is keyword, right? Static main and this access modifier, right? So I think these all things you should know. These are the very basic things, and we might get forgot, like why main method is static, we can override static method or not. And there are like constructor also, like we use constructor also, right? So practice the questions based on constructor as well, because constructor is also comes very very important topic. When can you overload the constructor, can you override the constructor, right? So these are questions which why we are not override the constructor, or right, if not. And even with the abstract method and the interface, can we overload an abstract method, can we override an interface, or these are the questions which is very commonly used in many of the interviews. Like if you are giving mid-level companies, which will give you a good hike, but they'll be asking you these basic questions, like OOPS concept, as I said, like I'm saying, right? Abstraction. So abstraction is very important. In OOPS concept, they only look for abstraction and overloading and overriding. So I think these three topics which you have to look into, and every basic of it, every point of it, it will be very important. And then interface, right? Why we are using interface, and how we are implementing interfaces, interface method, and where and all we will be using interface. So I think these all questions, yeah, it's very important. I think these five questions are very helpful for your interview. Now, okay, so if you have written, like if you're saying that you're working on database as well, you know the database as well. So as a 5 years or 3 years or 4 years experience, you should know database as well. At least basics of database is required if you're looking for a switch, because everyone, even though you're not working, but in the interview, they'll ask you every question. So joins is like based on joins, inner join, outer join, self join. I think these are the questions they'll be asking you, like subqueries, what is the difference between joins and subqueries? DDL and DML languages, what are DDL and DML languages? I think this is pretty much important. These are the pretty much topic in SQL and the database related stuff. And the TestNG annotation, so where and all, what are the annotations you have used it in TestNG annotation, why you are using data provider annotation. So when you have the same kind of data to be tested, like for example in a login application you have to test with different set of data, you can use data provider. What is a written type of data provider? I think these all questions will be asking you. And okay, as I said, overloading and overriding, you should know overloading and overriding, and what we can overload and what we cannot overload, and what we can override, what we cannot override, that you should know. Like we can overload the constructor, but we cannot override the constructor, right? So why we cannot do that? How we can overload an abstract method or abstract? Okay, they are like static method or not, or like that questions. What is invocation count? I think this is a question has been asked to me. Listeners in TestNG, what all listeners in TestNG? API calls. So if you are written like rest assured, and you have to, I think APIs are everywhere now. So if you don't know, also learn it and prepare it, and that's about it. But you cannot say that you have not worked on API, because many, like if you go for Walmart, they mostly work in APIs and stuff like that. Most of the organization works on like they do automations at the back end. So API calls, like we have post, get, put, delete, option, head. So I think you should know these all APIs. And BDD framework, I think, we know what EDD framework, but it's like most of the organizations work on BDD framework, at least the difference between TDD and BDD you should know. And if you don't know BDD, just learn the BDD. At least you learn it from YouTube. I think that is really great. There are a lot of options there to learn BDD. And I think BDD is very important because many of the organizations work with BDD. So you cannot go with TDD approach and stuff. And then there's a question of get window handles. So that also you should know, because they'll be asking you questions with different type of things. What is the written type of get window handle? How you handle multiple windows? So I think these are things you should know. Even frames, how to get out from the frames, and thread, what all threads you will be using, weights, explicit, implicit weight, and they'll be asking you the example of implicit and explicit weight. And I think that's about it. So wish you good luck, guys, and be positive and believe in yourself. You'll get the success. Prepare well, and thank you for watching the video. And let me know if this video is useful for you, so that I have more topics to cover. But just this is the trial video. So because I have given the interview in my organization for the promotion, I can share those questions as well. And I have multiple questions as well, because I was also searching for a good good job, but I got internally promoted, so I'm not searching as of now. But I had given a lot of interviews, and if you want, I can share a lot of topics, a lot more topics, because many of you have asked me through an mail or in the comment section. So if I'll get a like for this video, and I can put your suggestion in the comment section, or if you like it also, please put in comment, so that I'll make another video on the same topics. So until then, all the best. Thank you so much.